The Colour Party, comprising Marangus, Welsh, Ordman, Campbell and Davis, leads the parade, which is not only a fine spectacle, but also a competition in which the men and women are judged on their
impressive lineup now for the last event, 16 boats for the marathon. These boaties are strong, fearless, and they train hard. Although these boats are no longer used in rescues, they are part of the tradition of surf life-saving, and every club tries to maintain a boat, even though they cost 15,000 rands to import from Australia. Recently, a boat has been made at half the cost in South Africa, and Durban Surf are using it. But those oars out there are still 400 rands each, so you have to hang on to them even when the going gets rough. Woodridge School are out there, the first junior team to man a boat, and they're enjoying it, and they're rather proud of themselves, and rightly so. The sweep or helmsman alone can see what's happening out there. He steers, he calls the stroke, and tries to avoid too much trouble. And in they come, and how fitting it is that the last event should go to host club Kings Beach from Marine second and Fishhook third. But the Durban Surf Seniors have secured the national title
now
for the 20th.
Flags are up for the Surf Boat Championship, and so is the sea. It's going to be tough out there, and the boaties roll up their costumes and they wet their legs in the surf to ease the friction and get ready to crash into action. Out they go. Fishhook, Durban Surf, Milnerton, Kings Beach, Marine, Blue Water Bay. The B team, and that's the Blue Water Bay A team in trouble. Their sweep, Louis Bears, has lost it. Durban Surf 1A are suddenly clear. Ribbing, Clutie, Smith, Cleaver and Campbell. These are the men who train several hours a day, five or six early mornings a week, in craft that are virtually obsolete in this age of speedboat and helicopter rescues, but they cling to a tradition that makes these men proud. Biff Ribbink brings Durban Surf into another national title, but for the others, the race is definitely not over, and the surf pounds them without mercy.
And the aggregate result.
Yeah. Rink, you've done it again in the Mean Machine. What's the story of this year's race?
A lot of hard work, a lot of preparation, Kim. The sea's been a bit tricky this morning. My guys, we got our chance. We went for it. A few back, big ones at the back worried us. But we managed to get a run on the way home and held the course on the way in. And we managed to come through.
Louis Bayer's had a bit of bad luck on the left. Were you aware of what was happening to him?
Kim, in this sort of sea, you don't really worry about the guys on the left or right of you, because initially you've got to beat the sea before you can even take on a crew. So we couldn't see what is happening to Louis or any of the other crews. But when you go over a big wave at the back, you're quite sure that the boats behind you are going to get a hell of a lot of water in them.
Another event with a traditional flavor to it is the boat race, perhaps the highlight of the day and the most dramatic, where each team is tested to the limit. Well, before the final run home through the surf. And savoring an achievement.
Previously used in actual rescue work, the wooden surf boats have been replaced largely by the inflatable rubber rescue boats and are now used only in competitions. This now is a man's sport. Rugged, tough, dangerous, and skillful. Pulls as one man, guided, encouraged, and cajoled by the sweep, the man at the back who steers, sets the pace, and plots the course through the surf, round the marker buoys, and back again. The sweep watches the swells carefully. He must combine his knowledge of the sea with the muscle power of his oarsmen. A team is made up not only of men of strength, but also men of character. They must think alike, react alike, and share a common bond that goes far beyond pulling on an oar. Shows no mercy. One false move and the boat is in trouble. Then it's a case of keeping out of the way of the oars and taking whatever contingency measures you can. Provided the trouble occurs in the shallows, the boat can be manhandled to the beach and tipped out. You can't win them all, so better luck next time.